transform is an integral transform that I have discussed in previous lecture. It is an integral transform. Any of the integral transform has a particular task. The task is we actually convert time domain or x domain, that means function of time or function of x, into the function of f. This is the purpose of any of the integral transform. In our syllabus, we are going to study Laplace transform. But we have a lot of transform that we study actually. We may get Fourier transform, Fourier cosine transform, Fourier sine transform, Malin's transform, Z transform. A lot of transforms are possible. Later on in MTech study, we will study some of the transforms. In engineering syllabus, we are going to deal with the Laplace transform. Laplace transform is an integral transform whose sole purpose is to transform time domain function or x variable function into the s variable function. हम टाइम के फंक्शन को या एक्स के फंक्शन को एस के फंक्शन में बदलने के लिए जिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस का यूज करते हैं उसे हम इंटीग्रल ट्रांसफॉर्म बोलते हैं. Laplace transform एक इंटीग्रल ट्रांसफॉर्म. What we actually do, if we want to transform the function from time variable to s variable, we first integrate that function whose transformation we want. Let's say we want the transformation of ft. We want the integral transformation of function f of t. Let's say integral transform of f of t. That is obviously going to be fs. We may write fs, or we may write in this way, integral transform of f of t. And wherever we want the integral transform of ft, we integrate ft. What we do? We integrate ft. हम ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन करने के लिए फंक्शन का इंटीग्रेशन करते हैं, इसीलिए हमने ट्रांसफॉर्म का नाम क्या दिया, इंटीग्रल ट्रांसफॉर्म, बिकॉज वी इंटीग्रेट हियर. सिर्फ इंटीग्रेशन नहीं करते, इंटीग्रेशन के साथ साथ हम एक ट्रांसफॉर्म फंक्शन का मल्टीप्लाई भी करते हैं. वी डोंट ओनली इंटीग्रेट, वी रादर मल्टीप्लाई ट्रांसफॉर्म फंक्शन एज वेल. इस ट्रांसफॉर्म फंक्शन का एक नाम है कर्नल, और इसे हम ट्रांसफॉर्म फंक्शन बोलते हैं. वी इंटीग्रेट गिवन फंक्शन हूज ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन वी एक्चुअली वांट, बट इंटीग्रेशन इज डन आफ्टर मल्टीप्लाइंग विद ट्रांसफॉर्म फंक्शन. एज वी कीप ऑन चेंजिंग द ट्रांसफॉर्म फंक्शन, वी विल कीप ऑन गेटिंग डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ ट्रांसफॉर्म. एज वी कीप ऑन चेंजिंग इट, वी मे गेट Fourier transform, Fourier cosine transform, Fourier sine transform, Malin's transform, Z transform. Some of the transform that we may get, I have discussed some of them, but we are not supposed to discuss all of them. We are supposed to discuss only Laplace transform. Now what actually happened in Laplace transform, I am going to mention that. When we discuss Laplace transform, this transform function get confined. Right now in integral transform, we consider the integration in the limit minus infinite to infinite. But if we consider the Laplace transform only, KST get confined. How does it confine? It confine in this way. We consider it equal to 0 if t lies less than 0. And we consider it equal to e to the power minus st for all t greater or equal to 0. What does it mean? It simply means Laplace of any time domain function f of t is equal to, if I break this one, I have to break in this manner. I go from minus infinite up to 0 and then 0 to infinite. If I proceed minus infinite to 0, the value of function is 0. And 0 multiplied with anything is 0. Integration of 0 is obviously 0. And if we proceed 0 to infinite, its value is e to the power minus st. What does it mean? It simply means Laplace of time domain function ft is equal to 0 to infinite. I have to integrate 0 in the limit 0 to infinite. Whose integration is done over here? Kiska integration karna hai hame? Hame ft ka integration karna. और यहाँ पे ट्रांसफॉर्म फंक्शन e टू दी पावर माइनस एस टी यूज करना है. नाउ इट्स योर टास्क टू रिकॉल दिस फॉर्मूला. दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म. दिस एंटायर कन्वर्जन फॉर्मूला इज कॉल्ड डेफिनेशन ऑफ एल टी, डेफिनेशन ऑफ लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म. जब भी तुम्हें किसी भी फंक्शन का लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म निकालना है, सबसे पहले उस फंक्शन को e की पावर माइनस एस टी से मल्टीप्लाई करो, जिसका भी तुम्हें लाप्लास चाहिए. What are you supposed to do? You are supposed to multiply the function by e to the power minus st and then perform the integration in the limit 0 to infinity. जब भी तुम्हें किसी फंक्शन का लाप्लास निकालना है तो सबसे पहले उस फंक्शन को e to the power minus st से मल्टीप्लाई कर दो और बाद में उसका इंटीग्रेशन 0 से इनफाइनाइट में ले लो. दिस इज द वेरी बेसिक एंड इंपॉर्टेंट रूल दैट यू मस्ट रिकॉल हियर. इट इज कॉल्ड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ लाप्लास. By using definition, we have solved some of the Laplace transform and we have covered some of the Laplace transform. I'm just going to quickly revise all of them. I have first covered the Laplace transform of some elementary function. Let's start with the first elementary function. Put the heading Laplace transform of some elementary functions. I have some elementary functions whose Laplace transform should be known to us. The first elementary function is 1. Laplace of 1 is 1 by s. How to prove this one? I just have to multiply 1 by e to the power minus st and then I have to integrate in the limit 0 to infinity. We have already done this proof. Now I just suggest you to recall this one. There are some elementary functions that must be there in our memory. कुछ elementary functions हैं जिनके Laplace transform में याद होना चाहिए. पहला है Laplace of 1. The second one is Laplace of e to the power a t. It is always 1 divided by s minus a. The third function is Laplace of t to the power n. It is n factorial divided by s to the power n plus 1 for all n belonging to positive integer. And similarly, Laplace of t to the power n is also known to be gamma n plus 1 for all divided by s to the power n plus 1 for all n belonging to fractional value. Fractional value may be 1 by 2, 3 by 2, 5 by 2 and so on. We have also considered the Laplace of cos a t. Even we have proved the Laplace of cos a t. The Laplace of cos a t is coming out to be s divided by s square plus a square. Similarly, Laplace of sin a t is a divided by s square plus a square. Similarly, Laplace of cos hyperbola a t, it is coming out to be s divided by s square minus a square. And Laplace of sine hyperbola a t is a divided by s square minus a square. These are some basic 8 elementary functions that I suggest you all to recall. You should recall these 8 elementary functions. Can you recall this?
Yes.
Okay. Provided you all the seed, now we are going to solve some problems based on that seed. We have already covered some of the problems from this seed, and now in today's class, I'm going to cover a problem. Let's consider problem number 5th of your seed. In problem number 5th, a discontinuous function is known to us. The discontinuous function goes like this one. F of t is given to be sin t. It is problem number 5th of your series. F of t is given to be sin t when t varies from 0 to pi. And it is given to be 0 for all t greater than pi. This is the function that I have. I want the Laplace transform of this function. Let's start with the solution now. We all know the definition of Laplace transform. What is the definition? If you want the Laplace of any function ft, first multiply ft by e to the power minus st and then integrate in the limit 0 to infinite. This is the definition of Laplace transform. As per the definition, I'm supposed to integrate in the limit 0 to infinite. But right now, I have 0 to pi, then pi to infinite. I have to break the function. Because it breaks in fact. It is not continuous. It breaks a particular point, pi. I have to break the function, no doubt at all. Laplace of f of t here simply means integral from limit 0 to pi f of t e to the power minus st dt. Then integral pi to infinite f of t e to the power minus st dt. I have to integrate in this manner. Integration of function in limit 0 to pi, it is known to be sin t. I have to substitute the value sin t when I integrate in limit 0 to pi, because the value between this interval is given to be sin t. But in this interval, it is 0. 0 multiplied with anything is going to be 0. It is 0. We all know integral e to the power minus ax sin bx is equal to e to the power minus ax divided by a square plus b square a sin bx, it is plus e to the power ax minus b cos bx. This is the formula that I have already mentioned in previous class. Formula that I have mentioned earlier, we will get 0 to pi e to the power minus s t sin t dt. If we compare the same result, I will consider minus s to be a and 1 to be b. Just compare it, e to the power a x. In the place of x, I have t right now. Sin b x. In the place of b, I have 1 right now. Now, the Laplace of f of t is going to be e to the power ax divided by a square plus b square. And here, I have a sine bx minus sine 1t. Minus b means 1, cos bx means cos 1t. And I have to substitute the limit. That is going to be 0 to pi. Write it down. So we have पिछला नोट कर लिया है नोट्स नहीं मैंने एक्सप्लेन कर दिया है. मैंने रिपीट पूरा कर दिया है स्टार्टिंग से पूरा कर पाती. Now we should proceed further in this manner. Laplace of f of t is equal to, I'm going to substitute the limit now. Substitute the upper limit first. E to the power minus s pi divided by s square plus 1. This is the upper value. Now here, minus s sin pi minus s cos pi this is the upper limit that I have substituted, minus lower limit e to the power s 0 divided by s square plus 1 minus s sine 0 minus cos 0. This is the upper limit and this is the lower value, and I have substituted lower limit. Is it okay? Now you all know sine n pi is always 0. Sine n pi means sine kuch bhi pi, sine any pi. But any should be obviously integral value. Let's consider this graph of sine function. This is 0, this is pi, this is 2 pi, this is 3 pi, this is 4 pi, and so on. And similarly it goes here as well. For all integral pi, sine is going to be 0. For all integral value, sine is 0. Sine 1 pi, sine 2 pi, sine 3 pi, sine 1000 pi, sine 2000 pi, sine any integral pi is 0. But it doesn't happen with cos, do remember. For cos, let's consider the cos function as well. Many times we make use of these concepts. That's why you should understand when does it become 0 and when. At 0, it is 1. At pi, it is minus 1. At 2 pi, it is plus 1. At 3 pi, it is again minus 1. At 4 pi, it is again plus 1. What does it mean? It simply means sine cos odd pi is equal to minus 1. You can observe it. Cos 1 pi, cos 3 pi, it is going to be minus 1 here. And when we consider cos even pi,
plus 1.
That is cos 0 pi, cos 2 pi, it is going to be plus 1 here. Or we can simplify it, cos n pi is equal to minus 1 to the power n. And if it is even, that means minus 1 to the power even, that means plus 1. And if it is odd, that means n is obviously integral value. If it is odd, that means minus 1 to the power odd is going to be minus 1. Cos even pi is plus 1, cos odd pi is minus 1. These two things can be combined in this manner. In Fourier series, we basically make use of these concepts. But many times we make use even in the transform process. That's why you should put all these things in mind. What about the zero values of cos? Cos becomes 0 at this point, it is pi by 2. Cos becomes 0 at this point, it is 3 pi by 2. Cos becomes 0 at this point, it is 5 pi by 2. Means, cos becomes 0 at every odd pi by 2. At every odd pi by 2. Do remember all these things. Note it down immediately. Now, what can we conclude from this process, this discussion? We can simply conclude that sine pi is going to be 0. Is it the conclusion that we are going to draw? Sine pi is going to be 0. Sine any pi is 0. 0 multiplied with anything is 0. What about cos 1 pi? We have discussed right from cos odd pi is going to be minus 1. Cos 1 pi is obviously minus 1. Minus 1 multiplied with minus 1 is going to be plus 1. I am getting 0 plus 1 at this position. What about this particular process? This expression. Minus e to the power 0 is going to be 1 divided by s square plus 1. What about here? Sine 0 is going to be 0 and cos 0 is plus 1. Plus 1 means minus symbol is there. Minus 1. S plus 1 divided by s square plus 1. That simply means Laplace of given function ft is e to the power minus pi s plus 1 divided by s square plus 1. What are you observing right now? You have time domain function, but using all these processes, now you have s domain function. What I have actually done here? I have just converted time variable function into the s variable function. This is the same process, that is the integral transform. In any transform, we make use of kernel but we varies that kernel. In the case of Laplace transform, we put e to the power minus st in the place of k st. Is it okay? This is your answer. Where f of t is given to be t square plus 2 for all t lying between 0 to 2, and it is given by 6 if t lies between 2 to 3, and it is equal to 2t minus 5 if t lies 3 to infinite. Is it so? 2t minus 5 if t lies greater or equal to 3. You may write in this manner, or you may write as mentioned in your problem. It is mentioned in this manner. Is it okay? Let's start with this solution of this problem. We now know what the Laplace transform is. Whenever we consider Laplace of any function, we actually integrate that function in limit 0 to infinite after multiplying with a kernel e to the power minus st. This is the definition of Laplace transform that we are actually going to make use of here. But in this particular situation, I have to divide this limit in some portions. The first portion is 0 to 2. And then the second portion is 2 to 3. And then the third portion is 3 to infinite. I can divide it, no doubt at all, no problem at all. It is 0 to 2, and between this particular limit, I have ft, and ft is given as t squared plus 2. For this interval, ft is given as 6, and for this interval, it is given to be 2t minus 5. Substitute the function as per their limit consideration and interval consideration. 0 to 2, it is given as t squared plus 2, and I have to obviously multiply by e to the power minus s. Then I have to consider limit 2 to 3, and I have to consider function equal to 6 and multiply by e to the power minus st and integrate. And again, I have to consider 3 to infinite, 2t minus 5 as a function, multiply by e to the power minus st and integrate. Is it okay? Now, I have discussed what the Bernoulli rule is. Can you recall the Bernoulli rule? By using Bernoulli rule, we can quickly find out such integration. Even we can make use of bipart rule, but Bernoulli rule is more efficient in solving such problems. What is it? Whenever we want to integrate such functions where u and v are function of x, u और v x के functions हैं, और हमें इस integration को करना है, तो what does Bernoulli rule explain? Bernoulli rule क्या कहता है? कि सबसे पहले u को constant मान के अलग कर लो, और v का एक बार integration लो, minus u का एक बार differentiation, v का एक बार और integration, u का एक बार और differentiation, v का एक बार और integration, और ये process कब तक करते चलो? हाँ, alternative आएगा, यहाँ minus में यहाँ plus, फिर minus. और ये कब तक करते जाओ? जब तक जीरो आना शुरू ना हो जाए. चलो एक प्रोसेस हम यहाँ 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 और यहाँ करते हैं, यहाँ कोई जरूरत नहीं है, तो मैं तुम्हें इसका इंटीग्रेशन करके दिखाता हूँ बाय यूजिंग बर्नौली. करें इसको ठीक. इसे हमें फर्स्ट एज्यूम करना होगा, इसे हमें सेकंड. ये रूल ऑब्वियसली आई लेट से आया है. आई लेट में हम इनवर्स को पहले एज्यूम करते हैं, ठीक है, फिर लॉग को, फिर अलजेब्रा को, फिर ट्रिग्नोमेट्री को, फिर एक्सपोनेंशियल को. ये एक्सपोनेंशियल है, इसे हम बाद में एज्यूम करेंगे, और ये अलजेब्रा है, इसे हम पहले एज्यूम करेंगे. अब इसके बाद बेटा फर्स्ट, यहाँ पे फर्स्ट में बोल के हम बोलेंगे यू और वी का इंटीग्रेशन. वी का इंटीग्रेशन क्या पता है तुम्हें? ई टू द पावर माइनस एस टी, और माइनस एस टी के डिफरेंशिएशन से डिवाइड करेंगे. क्या होगा माइनस एस टी का डिफरेंशिएशन? माइनस. लेकिन याद रखो बेटा, इस माइनस सिंबल को कभी भी बाहर मत करना. यू को एक साथ रखना और वी का जो भी इंटीग्रेशन आता है एक साथ एक ब्रैकेट में रखना. माइनस, अब इस यू का हम फिर से एक बार डिफरेंशिएशन लेंगे, 2t, फिर से क्या पहली बार ले रहे हैं डिफरेंशिएशन, इसका फिर से इंटीग्रेशन लेंगे, और इसके बाद हम इसका फिर से डिफरेंशिएशन लेंगे और इसका एक बार और इंटीग्रेशन लेंगे। आया समझ में? दिस इज द इंटीग्रेशन दैट वी हैव डन। अब यहाँ पे टू का डिफरेंशिएशन जीरो है। फाइव पार्ट भी यही काम करने हैं। यही काम यदि हम बाई पार्ट से करते तो थोड़ा टाइम लगता। यदि हमें इंटीग्रेशन लिमिट दे दिया जाए जीरो से टू तो हम यहाँ पे हर जगह लिमिट की बात कर लेंगे। चलो कर लेते हैं लिमिट की। सबसे पहले हम अपर लिमिट टू रख लेते हैं। टी की जगह टू रखना है आपको, तो क्या होगा? टू टू द फोर प्लस टू सिक्स माइनस सिक्स ई टू द पावर माइनस एस एंड टी की जगह हमने टू रखा है माइनस टू एस डिवाइड बाय एस। माइनस हमने यहाँ कंसीडर कर लिया। फिर हम टी की जगह क्या रख रहे हैं? टू। ये हो जाएगा माइनस का फोर ई टू द पावर माइनस टू एस डिवाइड बाय एस स्क्वायर। यहाँ भी हम क्या रख रहे हैं? टी की जगह टू रख रहे हैं। ये हो जाएगा टू ई टू द पावर माइनस टू एस डिवाइड बाय एस क्यूब और ये माइनस सिंबल आके क्या बना देगा इसको? प्लस से माइनस बना देगा। अपर लिमिट हमने रख लिया, माइनस लोअर लिमिट। लोअर लिमिट रखते हैं, सबसे पहले लोअर लिमिट यहाँ रखते हैं जीरो प्लस टू, ये टू हो जाएगा और ये माइनस माइनस प्लस हो जाएगा। टू ई टू दी पावर, ई टू दी पावर जीरो ऑब्वियसली क्या होने वाला है? वन। तो हमें केवल क्या मिल गया? टू डिवाइड बाय एस। यहाँ पे बेटा जीरो रखेंगे, जीरो इंटू एनी थिंग इज गोइंग टू बी जीरो, ये पूरा टर्म जीरो हो गया। यहाँ जीरो रखेंगे तो अपर लिमिट माइनस, सबसे पहले तो लोअर लिमिट वाला माइनस आएगा, ई टू दी पावर जीरो वन हो जाएगा डिवाइड बाय माइनस एस क्यूब, ये प्लस बन जाएगा। ये पूरा सॉल्व होके आ गया जब हमने लिमिट जीरो से टू रखा है। ये जीरो से टू लिमिट रखने पे हमें आंसर मिल गया। यू कैन अज्यूम इट इक्वल टू फर्स्ट इंटीग्रेशन। दिस इज द आंसर ऑफ दिस इंटीग्रेशन, आंसर ऑफ दिस एंटायर इंटीग्रेशन। व्हाट अबाउट द सेकंड पार्ट? इफ आई वांट टू इंटीग्रेट 6 e टू द पावर माइनस एस टी in limit 2 to 3, we can integrate this one as well. Consider 6 as the common part, as it is a constant portion. E to the power minus st divided by minus s and the limit is 2 to 3. Substitute limit 3 first. It is going to be minus 6 divided by s, e to the power minus 3s divided by s. Minus lower limit, if you substitute 2 in the place of t, you will get this value and minus minus it becomes plus. This is your second integration that I have considered here. Let's say it is A equation and these are first, second. Is it okay? Now proceed towards the next integration, the last integration that we have. 3 to infinite 2t minus 5 e to the power minus st dt. This is u. U. Integration of this portion is going to be e to the power minus st divided by minus s. Minus. Differentiation of u, it is going to be 2. Again the integration of this one, e to the power minus st divided by s square. And the limit that I have right now is 3 to infinite. Do you have any doubt up to this point? If you face any doubt, ask immediately. Note it down up to this point. कोई डाउट है तो मैं पूछना है बिना हेजिटेशन। जल्दी इसको स्पीड से कर दिया क्या? आ गया समझ में? अब बेटा तुम लोग सॉल्व कर लो, कंप्लीट सॉल्व कर लो। e to the power minus infinite हमेशा जीरो होता है. Substitute the limit now, e to the power minus infinite is going to be 0, upper limit is going to be 0, entire upper limit will be 0, minus lower limit, 6 minus 5, 1, but we have minus symbol as well, minus minus plus, e to the power 3s minus 3s divided by s. Minus lower limit means plus 2, e to the power
minus
3s minus 3s divided by, this is your answer. Is it so? This is the third equation that we have. Now substitute the value from first, second and third in equation number A. Can you substitute all these values? Substitute all these values. If you substitute all these values here, you will get the first term is equal to, write all these things, minus 6 e to the power minus 2s divided by s, minus 4 e to the power minus 2s divided by s square, minus 2 e to the power minus 2s divided by s cube, plus 2 divided by s, plus 2 divided by s. Okay, in the place of this integration, I have to substitute the second value. But what about the second value? This is minus 6 divided by s, e to the power minus 3s. Is it s square?
Yes, sir.
It is s square. Because I have substituted minus 6 divided by s, e to the power minus 3s. It is not s square. It is actually single s. What do you say? Because I have just substituted 3. How it comes? It can't be s square. I have committed mistake here. Is it okay? Minus 6 divided by s e to the power minus 3s plus 6 e to the power minus 2s divided by s. And now, in the place of this integral, I can substitute e to the power minus 3s divided by s plus 2 divided by s square e to the power minus 3s. Is it all right? Do you have any problem up to this point? Where is it? Where is this one? Now you have to simplify the expression as much as you can. Simplify karo jitna ho sakta hai. Consider e to the power minus 3s first. You will get 1 divided by s here. Then you will get minus 6 divided by s here. Some more terms are involved? No. Now you should consider e to the power minus 2s. If you will consider e to the power minus 2s, you will get a term here that is minus 6 divided by s, and you will get a term here that is minus 4 divided by s square. You will get a term here that is minus 2 divided by s cube. You will get a term here as well that is plus 6 divided by s. Is there some more terms involved? Have I considered this term? When I have considered e to the power minus 3s, I have not considered this term. It is 2 divided by s cube. Have I covered all terms that contains e to the power minus 2s? I think so. I have covered all the terms. Is there some more terms involved? Some constant terms are involved. 2 to the power s plus 2 to the power s cube. Is it all right? These are the terms that are involved here. Now further, if you can simplify, do simplify. Can you simplify further? E to the power minus 3s. Consider s square as the common part. Can you consider s square as the common part? If you consider s square as the common part, you will get s minus 6s plus 2 here. And if you consider again s cube as the common part, you will get minus 6s square minus 4s minus 2 plus 6s square as the common part. And here, if you consider 1 divided by s cube as the common part, you will get 2s square plus 2 as the value. Again, e to the power minus 3s divided by s square, 2 minus 5s plus e to the power minus 2s divided by s cube. And here I have, you can cancel out these two terms, you will get minus 4s minus 2. And here if you consider 2 as the common, you will get s square plus 1. This is your answer. And further, if you want to simplify it, you can simplify in this manner. You can consider 2 as the common. You will get 2s plus 1. And here, this is your final answer.